Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about parallel plate waveguide and its different modes which is possible, like TE, TM and TEM mode. Let us consider a parallel plate waveguide having two plates. One plate is at y equal to d, another one is at y equal to 0. So there is a separation of d between these two plates. Also, assume the width of this plate as w, which is oriented in x direction. And this parallel plate waveguide is kept along the z direction so that wave can propagate in z direction. As we know that for TEM mode, our Helmholtz equation converts into the potential form, and in potential form it is given as del T square phi xy equal to 0. And this equation is valid for x from 0 to w, because w is the width of waveguide, and y from 0 to d as the separation between the waveguide plates is d. Now let us assume that the bottom plate potential is 0 and the top plate potential is V naught. So the bottom plate potential phi x 0, because the bottom plate will have the coordinate x comma 0 for any z, and similarly for top plate the coordinate will be x comma d, so d is the y coordinate of top plate, so it's given by 0 and v naught. So we can say that the bottom plate is actually the ground. Now let us apply this boundary condition for solving this equation. As we know that the variation of potential will be only along y direction but not in x direction, so this equation will converge into only x direction, and if we solve for that we will get the solution as phi xy equal to a plus by, as the potential varies only in y direction. Now let us apply these two boundary conditions. First is phi x 0 equal to 0. So let's put that into this equation. So we will get phi x 0 equal to 0 and at y equal to 0. So if we put y equal to 0, we'll get that a equal to 0. So if a is 0, we have only phi x y equal to by. Now let us apply the second boundary condition, which says phi xd is v naught at y equal to d. So when we put y equal to d, the potential is v naught, hence the second constant b is v naught by d. Apply this constant in our solution. So phi xy equal to by, and b is v naught by d, so it's v naught by dy. So we can say that the potential is phi xy, which is v naught by d into y, and we can find from the potential we can find electric field by using the gradient formula, which is minus of negative of gradient of potential is electric field. In this case this is transverse potential, so the transverse electric field will be negative of gradient of this. So we can find that, and our electric field will be minus V naught by d Ay, because potential varies only in y direction, our electric field will be oriented in y direction. Now by knowing this electric field, we can find the total electric field. So far we have only taken x and y coordinate here, so the electric field here is in x and y direction, And Z direction is already known, which is depending upon the propagation constant, because our wave is propagating in Z direction. So the total electric field can be written as the transverse electric field into e to the power minus jkz, where this e to the power minus jkz component is phase component, which shows that this wave is propagating in Z direction. Also, this k, which is known as propagation constant or phase constant, which is omega under root mu epsilon, as we know this. So from this electric field, we can find the magnetic field, which is 1 by eta. Eta is intrinsic impedance, Az cross electric field. So to calculate magnetic field, we can apply this formula. It's cross multiplication of Az and electric field, which gives Az cross, the electric field direction is in y direction. So z cross y will be minus x. So we can get H xyz, which is the total electric, total magnetic field, as V naught by eta d e to the power minus jkz ax. So if we take z cross y, we will get minus x direction. So already we had a negative sign here, so minus minus will become positive, and we will get this expression for the magnetic field, total magnetic field. Now to calculate the voltage on top plate, we have already assumed that voltage is V naught, but in that case we have taken only xy variation. If we take z variation, there is e to the power minus jkz multiplied into this. We can also find using the integration ey dy from 0 to d, and we can find this expression for voltage on top plate. Now current, to find current, we can use this expression, which is surface current density dot az dx. So to find js, we have to take the cross multiplication of unit vector and the magnetic field, and we can calculate it as W V naught by eta d e to the power minus jkz. So the characteristic impedance of parallel plate waveguide can be found by taking the ratio of voltage and current of top plate. So this is the voltage and current on the top plate. By taking the ratio, we can find that the characteristic impedance is eta d by W, which is constant throughout a particular waveguide, because d and W, these are the dimension of waveguide, so it will be constant. And intrinsic impedance is under root mu by epsilon, which is also constant. So the phase velocity of this is given by omega by beta, which is equal to 1 by under root mu epsilon. And also for your reference, the attenuation due to dielectric loss, the formula is alpha d equal to k 10 delta by 2 nipper per meter. This is valid for TEM mode. Now let us take the TM mode. TM mode means transverse magnetic mode. That means all the magnetic fields are transverse. So there is no longitudinal magnetic field. That means longitudinal magnetic field Az equal to 0. And from Helmholtz equation, we know that for TM mode, the Helmholtz equation is written as del square by del y square plus kc square of Ez xy equal to 0. Since Hz is 0, we'll write Helmholtz equation in terms of Ez, and then we will solve it. So the solution of this, because there is only one variation in y direction, so solution of this equation is Ezxy equal to A sin kcy plus B cos kcy. And the boundary condition will be, since the solution is in terms of Ez, we will try to find boundary condition in terms of Ez. Ez is tangential on top plate and bottom plate. That means it will be zero as per the boundary condition at top plate and bottom plate. So top plate y equal to d and y equal to zero. At these plates, the tangential component will be zero. So ezxy equal to zero. Let us put this. When we put the first condition at y equal to zero, we will find b equal to zero, which is our one of the constant. Similarly, when we put the second condition at y equal to d, we will find that kcd equal to n pi, and hence kc equal to n pi by d. So we can write ezxy as a, because b is 0, so we have ezxy equal to a sine kcy. So a sine n pi by d y, and a is a constant which will depend upon the different value of n. That's why this constant term we will write as a n. So now it is a n sine n pi y by d, and total electric field, by assuming the phase of the wave, we can just multiply with it by minus j beta z, and we will get the total electric field in z direction, that is E z x y z, is given by this expression, where beta is under root k square minus kc square, and kc is nothing but called as cutoff wave number. Now to find the transverse component, by knowing this Ez, we can find all the transverse component, because only one longitudinal component is there, that is Ez, and Ez is already zero. So transverse component can be found by using this expression. For derivation of this expression, you can refer my video on general equation for TEM, TE and TM waves. So by taking this differentiation, we will find Hx equal to this, where this kc square and n pi by d, n pi by d is nothing but kc, so kc, one of the kc will cancel, and we have denominator only kc. Similarly, we can find other three fields, hy, so hy is del z by del x, so the variation with respect to x is already 0, so hy is 0. Similarly, ex will be also 0, as it is partial derivative with respect to x, and ey again can be calculated and found as minus jb by kc n cos n pi y by d, it were minus j beta z. Now here we can see, if we put n equal to 0, if we put n equal to 0, kc is n pi by d, so kc will become 0. And if kc becomes 0 in our expression, here if kc is 0, beta becomes k. So if beta is k, and that is omega under root mu epsilon, in that case, ez will be 0. That means if hz is already 0, and we make ez also 0, it means this is nothing but TEM mode. So if I put n equal to 0, which is called as TM0 mode, in general, we will say that TMN mode for n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. For n equal to 0, we call it as TM0 mode. That will be just equivalent to TEM mode. And all the expression of this will be equivalent to TEM mode, because we can see that the fields EY and HX will become constant, just like TEM mode. Now the beta is under root k square minus kc square. If k is greater than kc, this beta will be real. If k is less than kc, beta will become imaginary. Beta is real means there is propagation of waves, called as propagating waves. If k is less than kc, beta is imaginary, which is non-propagating waves. And due to this propagation and non-propagation of waves, there is a cutoff frequency which exists. That means below that frequency, the TM wave TEM mode wave cannot be propagated, and that cutoff frequency can be calculated as FC, which is equal to omega C by 2 pi, and omega C is KC into VP, and by putting all these values, VP is 1 by under root mu epsilon, we can calculate the cutoff frequency, which is N by 2D under root mu epsilon. And the impedance, wave impedance of TM mode, which is denoted as ZTM, equal to minus EY by HX. So by putting this value, it's beta by omega epsilon or beta eta by K. So this is how we can calculate the wave impedance in TM mode. The phase velocity is omega by beta, and in TM mode, this phase velocity depends upon the frequency. So it's a function of frequency. Lambda z is guide wavelength, which can be calculated by 2 pi by beta, and the cutoff wavelength, which is lambda c, can be calculated by 2d by m. Now let us see the TE mode. In TE mode, since the electric field should be transverse, so Ez will be 0 and it will become del square by del y square plus kc square, hz xy equal to 0. So in this case, we will take hz in Helmholtz equation and solve it. So the solution will be again similar, but we don't have any boundary condition in terms of hz. So we will try to find out boundary condition in terms of electric field. So if there is no Ez, we have to look for some other electric field which is tangential to these two plates. So other field will be, let us look into the waveguide again, and here Ez on top plate will be in this direction, and another field will be Ex, which will be tangential to the plate. Ey will be normal to the plate. So we are going to write the boundary condition in terms of Ex. So Ex is 0 at y equal to 0, that means at bottom plate, and it will be also 0 at y equal to d at top plate. So at the bottom plate and top plate, Ex will be 0. Let us use this boundary condition. For that, first of all, we have to convert this Hz in terms of transverse field Ex. And by applying the same formula as we have applied earlier, we can write this. And next is apply the boundary condition. So when Ex is 0, at y equal to 0, when we apply the boundary condition, it gives A equal to 0. That means one of the constant in this is 0. So we have only the second term with B, and also Kc is n pi by d when we equate with the second boundary condition. So we can write Hz, the total electric field in terms of xyz, as since A is 0, so this term is 0, we have B cos Kcy. So for B we write Bn cos, for Kc n pi by d y, and for total electric field write the Z propagating wave, that is the phase of this is e to the power minus j beta z. So we have Hz equal to this. Now from this Hz we can calculate Ex and Hy. So again Ex will be j omega mu by kc bn sin n pi y by d e to the power minus j beta z, and Hy will be jb by kc bn sin n pi y by d e to the power minus j beta z. Ey and Hx will be 0 with obvious reason that the variation of magnetic field or electric field in x direction is not there. So the partial differentiation will be 0. So Ey and Hx is 0, and hence we can calculate the cutoff frequency for TE mode also as n by 2d under root mu epsilon, and the wave impedance as Ex by Hy, which is omega mu by beta equal to K eta by beta. So we have found all the electric and magnetic fields for all the modes, including TE, TM and TEM. You can calculate the cutoff frequency for different mode like TM1, TM2, TE1, TE2 and so on. By taking the value of N, we can calculate the cutoff frequency and we can determine which modes can be propagated for a given condition. Thank you.